It is an interesting story. I've been married 40 years, and in any relationship over 40 years, there certainly is ups, there's downs, there's challenges and difficult times. And probably about in 2003, I went on a men's retreat, and the fellow who was hosting it challenged us with what would be the prayer request that would radically change your life. Mm-hmm. And as a matter of fact, I still have the 3x5 file card. You can see it's really
A bit tattered.
Tattered, but the prayer request, you could read it. You could read it.
Okay. Prayer request, that I will make my wife a treasure.
A treasure, yeah.
And this is from 6/27/03. That was your prayer request.
That was my prayer request.
Before the weekend or as a result of the weekend?
In the weekend, in the weekend while I was there. And that came out of the fact that at that stage of our life, separating or getting a divorce, those kind of options were totally off the table. Mm-hmm. But the idea that, you know, you're going to live the rest of your life with the woman that you married, why couldn't it be the very best? You know, why should it just be average?
Now, and you'd been married for how long at this point?
At that time, probably 34 years.
Okay.
All right. And so that was my prayer. And it was interesting, but 6 months, back in October of that year, I'm in the health club at Ridgefield, and I bump into a guy named Richard. I'll leave his last name out for purposes, but we became good friends.
Okay.
But Richard was a very successful attorney who had made a lot of money in real estate. Mm-hmm. And he had this great plan of that if he found the 10 things to buy a building, buy a home, he would do one every day until he would purchase that property.
Okay.
And it was very methodical. And I remember when I was listening to Richard talk, he was really ticking me off. And I told him that. I mean, I told him he just really annoyed me because at that time in my life, I was really not looking for materialism to satisfy those inner needs. Mm-hmm. I was reading a book called Search for Significance, where my significance would be something far greater than material things. Mm-hmm. Well, as I'm walking out of this health club, I just shot up a quick prayer. Mm-hmm. And I think the phone is coming in.
Yeah, no.
And the quick prayer was, you know, like, Lord, that was an interesting conversation, and I know things don't happen by accident. You know, how could this ever be useful for me? And all of a sudden, this thought came into my mind is that the concept was great, but the object was wrong. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, it clicked is that the object was wrong. You know, if I could come up with the 10 things that would capture the heart of my wife, mm-hmm. that would make sense. So in the next 48 hours...
So the book he was writing, or the concept he had, was 10 things to buy commercial property.
Mm-hmm.
And you thought, well, that's
acquiring
fine.
Acquiring wealth.
Ten steps towards success.
Right.
You were looking for 10 steps towards significance.
Yes.
In your relationship.
In my relationship with my wife. Yeah. And within 48-hour period, all of a sudden, these 10 things started to come. Mm-hmm. You know. And I said, wow. You know. And I wanted to experiment with it. So, for 6 months, without telling my wife anything, I just did these 10 things.
Okay.
I did one a day. So like step number one I did on the first, step number two on the second. And over a 6 month period, without telling her anything but doing these steps, mm-hmm. One evening she said to me, you know, I want to tell you, John, that that I love you now more than I have in the past 20 years.
Wow.
And that was huge because my wife is not one to just give out compliments. I mean, you know, I mean, so that was a major, major deal. So what I did was I made a copy of these 10 things. And when I was traveling, I had territory from New York to L.A. and, you know, the U.S. I had multiple copies, and you always get in conversations on the airplanes, at least I do, and it's amazing on how many guys...
You're the guy that you sit next to on the airplane that gets... No, I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So, but, you know, I'm going to say well over 50% of the time, if you're talking on an airplane and you're on a long trip, it gets to kids, wife, family. And it always focuses around marriage and relationships, and I would say, hey, you know, I've used these 10 things. You know, give me a buck and you could have a list.
Okay.
And the reason I charged the dollar because it had to have some value.
Sure.
So, over the course of about a year.
Hold on 1 second, because I want to jump in. I don't want to steal your thunder, but for those of you watching, the 10 things you might want to write this down, ladies. You might want to write this down for your husband. The 10 things towards a better marriage. First, listen to her. Second, we're going to go through these in depth. Second, value her. She's a priority. This is talking about your wife. Third, spend time with her. She's a priority. 4, acknowledge her worth. Say it. I've read this book. It's brilliant. 5, laugh and enjoy her more. 6, accept her as she is. Don't try to change her. 7, show her compassion. 8, enjoy life together. 9, don't criticize her. Appreciate her. And 10, do things for her that mean something to her.
Yes.
Okay, because I got my wife tickets. They had the professional wrestling at the Danbury Arena.
Really,
I mean, it was going to be great, and I got her the tickets, but that didn't...
You must have been before you read the book.
I hadn't got it. It was the 10th one. It was the last chapter.
You get a pass on that, you know.
Okay, so you tried these 10 things with your wife.
Yes, and then I would...
But you didn't tell her.
No.
Okay.
And so then I did it over a 6-month period, you know, just giving it out to guys on the airplane.
Right.
And I'll never forget, I gave one guy my business card, which I normally don't do, but I got an email, and it said, John, I've been doing this thing for 3 months. It's revolutionized my marriage. Thank you so much.
Wow.
And I got a kick out of it, and I would share it with more guys. And then probably about a year after that, I'm getting on a plane to L.A., and I just sense this inner voice saying, I want you to write about it.
Huh.
You know? And I go, wow. And I said, the way of testing that out is that from New York to L.A., I wrote the introduction of the first chapter. It just flowed. It just really flowed. And what was interesting, in the next year, 9 of the chapters were written in the air.
Wow.
And one was written in a hotel room in Louisville.
Okay.
I even tried, because I didn't even want to tell my wife I was writing about it. I wanted to know. She didn't even know anything about it at this time, the book, the whole deal. She's totally in the dark, just really... receiving how it's working. And even when, you know, she would go to work and I would try to do a chapter at home, it just didn't flow. So it was all up in the air, and then one in Louisville.
But 30,000 feet,
yes.
It's flowing.
It's flowing.